Hey guys, it's Julie. I'm a third year medical student. I'm just going to give some quick advice about what I did in term four to be successful. So just some overall general advice. I mean, pathology is really about understanding the changes in physiology. So if you did well in term one, term four seems a lot easier. And I think having that solid foundation really helped me out in term four. One big thing is you want to try to understand like why a disease actually is presenting this way. If you stop memorizing certain things, it really, you know, if you really get an understanding of why things happen, you end up getting more questions in the long run because you're not just memorizing, say, one fact. You've memorized one concept, which could probably get you 10 questions instead of just one. And another big thing is learn how to describe your buzzwords. So there's different buzzwords in physiology that you'll see, you know, in a lot of different SGU tests or in different, you know, things like pathoma. What you want to do is figure out how you would describe those in words instead of just using that simple buzzword, because when you actually get to step, they're going to describe that. They're not actually going to give you that, you know, that trigger word. All of the pharmacology and the microbes, I mean, it definitely ends up being a lot, you know, it's on every exam. One thing that I think really helped me be successful for those two is I did Onchi for the very first time. So I used Onchi, I did use the Onking deck. And what I did was I essentially created filtered decks for these. So any microbe that was covered, any pharmacology that was covered from that day's lecture, I would make a filtered deck and I would pull those in. Term three and term four really feels like a marathon. I mean, extremely long. I was in Grenada for all of the 6 months, so I know it's different for you guys because you're at home. So hopefully that helps. You know, you get to see your family, you can hang out with your friends, you could do, you know, a lot more things, I guess, in the US than you can in Grenada. But one thing I do want to recommend, term three, term four is so long. If you need to take a day off, just take the day off, because trying to work through fatigue, work through not being motivated, work through just mental stress, it's not beneficial at all. So just take the day off, come back the next day, refreshed and ready to go. All right, exam one. So immuno, pharm, micro. As always, I always make my own notes. Based off the lectures, I did not use pathoma. Technically, I didn't use sketchy here either, but I did do the Onking cards. So essentially, I learned the videos from doing the cards, but I did not watch the videos themselves. Same thing for the micro. I didn't watch the videos, but I did do all of the Onking cards for any of the micro or pharm discussed in the lecture. But honestly, I think the biggest thing is making your own notes and then just keeping up with reviewing those. As always, I always redo the IMCQs twice. So I do them, you know, when we have to go and do the clickers. And then that weekend, I redo that set of IMCQs. So I will do that every week. Say the second week, I have another IMCQ question. That weekend, I would review and redo those again. And then for creating the filtered decks, essentially what you can do is you can go to browse and you can type in the tag for the card. So you can type in, say, you know, strep pneumo and pull up all the cards about strep pneumo. And then what I did is I created my own deck out front, just called like SGU micro or high yield micro and farm. And I would pull in those cards into that separate deck. I would pull them actually out of the, you know, LOL not a cop. I would pull them out of there. So I knew that this was the deck that I needed to do every day to keep up my reviews and my new cards, because that was more consistent with the SGU schedule. And then one thing I do different, I did do quite a bit of RX questions during term four. I was almost done with the whole question bank by the end of term four, because I had done it in term one, term two, term three. And by the end of term four, I was almost done with the whole question bank. But, you know, time permitting, I would have done all of the micro. I would have done all of the related farm question, all of the related micro questions. I didn't get to all the farm and micro. And I thought that that was fine because I was constantly doing the Onchi card. So that was essentially kind of like me doing more questions in a way. But immuno, I did all of the RX questions for. Just an example of my notes. I know I've showed these a bunch of times, but I'm taking pictures from SGU lectures. I'm putting my own notes in my own description that is best for me to understand. I'm not writing these for anybody else to use or to review. I mean, I did share them with some of my friends, but they're in my own words, something that I would understand, you know? So if I give my notes to somebody else, they might have to kind of, you know, write out little reminders of what I'm saying, so it's better for them. But, you know, always make your notes for you. Exam two, so this was cardio and renal path with PharM. Everyone said this was the hardest test, and I'm very analytical. I've done, worked in pharmaceuticals and dietary supplements, so I think PharM in general is much easier for me to retain than a lot of other things. So this test in particular was not very difficult, I didn't think. For me anyway. I mean, the amount of material learning for every exam is hard, but sometimes you get lucky in what's on it. So for me, I'm very good at PharM, and that came naturally to me. If you'll notice though, my test score, so like 91, 94, almost 91, but my overall grade here in term four was only a 91.6. So the hardest part for the terms for me, like they are in every term, is actually the OSCEs, whatever you guys call them now. I don't think I've ever gotten an A on those. I'm always in like the 80s, and that actually brought my grade down quite a bit. And I think there's like four or five of them in term four. So for this test, kind of the same things. I made all my own notes, redid the IMCQs. I've created filter decks for the PharM and the micro for this as well. It was getting a little bit harder to keep up with all the reviews, plus doing new cards. So I set Anki to where I always did my new cards first because I knew I wanted to always keep up with new material and not forget that stuff too. And then I did write my reviews later in the day. So I did my new cards first. That way, at least I had one, you know, two, three passes at everything. You know, maybe I didn't get to five plus passes, you know, on the Anki card scale anyway, but I had gotten everything at least, you know, one to three times, probably more than that, to be honest. Again, things I would do different. I would have done all of the Rx pathology questions. I did do PharM and micro. Actually, I take that back. I think this should say I would have done the PharM and the micro. I did do the pathology for cardio and renal, because I wasn't doing flashcards for those. Again, more notes. I'm color coding things. One big thing I really like to do too is when I'm reviewing my weekly notes on like Sunday or Saturday, I'm specifically going through and highlighting like key things for me to look for in the stems, key things, you know, that will help me identify what the disease is, what the pathology is, and what things I need to be looking for that can help me distinguish one thing from another. So when I make these notes, I'm not doing this highlighting right away. When I come back and review, that's when I do this highlighting. And then the third time I look at this, I'm literally only looking at my highlighted words. When I look at this the fourth and fifth time, same thing. I'm looking at my highlighted words. Maybe I'm briefly glancing at other things, but my eyes are drawn to the things that I've personally told myself. These are the highest yield things to remember. And they help me distinguish, you know, say large vessel, different vasculitis from the other vasculitis, I guess, if that makes sense. So, yeah. Exam three. So this was pulmonary and hematology. I thought hematology was very difficult. From my notes, again, make my notes, did my MCQs. I was very consistent with the Anking deck for doing, pulling out my PharM and my micro. For this exam, I did do the SNL-DES practice test. I have been unable to find the Google Drive for you guys. I don't know if he shut it down or what, but you know, if you cannot make a practice or you can't find his practice test, one thing I recommended to somebody, because I've gotten a lot of messages about that, is make your own practice test on Rx. You know, you can set Rx up to specifically only give you information you want to see. So what I would do is I would do pulmonary path, pulmonary PharM, you know, heme path, and probably heme PharM. And I would make 150 questions out of that and take it just like a regular exam and see how I did. Exam four, so this is GI EndoRepro. this is the last test. At this point, I was just exhausted. I hadn't seen my family in 6 months. I was mentally and just physically fatigued. I took a lot of days off, and I recommend that. I mean, at the end of the day, like, your mental health has to be one of the top priorities, because if you go into an exam just like completely trashed and burnt out, it's just not going to end well. So I took quite a few days off, which is very unusual for me. So I took, I needed time, and I recommend that if you need it, you need it. One thing I did is I make my own notes. I did do my on-king cards. Like I said, I took a lot of time off. Things I would do again, I did not review my notes very much. I would have made notes for micro and GI. I actually didn't get to all the notes that I wanted to, because I took so many days off and just, you know, needed to rest. I would have done any RX questions. I didn't do any at this point. And I didn't even redo my IMCQs because I was taking so many days off. I actually went to Sandals for a few days too, and highly, highly recommend, if you guys do get to go to Grenada, you can ask for the student discount. You actually pay like the local rate for Sandals. So it's like thousands of dollars off. Yeah, 10 out of 10 would definitely recommend. That's really it. As always, you guys can shoot me messages on Facebook. My last name is Hansen, so H-A-N-S-E-N. If you're watching my YouTube channel, please like and subscribe. Eventually, when my schedule gets a little better, I'm going to be making videos called This or That, and it's going to be essentially breaking down two topics that are really confusing. So say like nephrotic syndrome, systolic versus diastolic heart failure. I have a lot of plans to do just like free teaching, because I think there are too many people taking over your guys' Facebook page, charging ridiculous amounts. So I'm going to try and put, you know, free information for you guys to get good teaching tutorials, good ways to kind of break things down in its simplest form, and get you to where you're feeling confident that you could tackle any question and crush all the exams that you're, you know, going to be taking in the years ahead. So anyway, thanks for watching. If you made it this far, super appreciate it. Like I said, please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks. Bye.